Camcork has our new hit game show, Win My Wage, at 4:15. First on 4, a cinematic countdown.
You don't need to buy a new TV for the switchover, as nearly all existing TVs can be converted to digital.
See that, but Cara was curtsying, doing a little curtsy to the crowd.
Well, you never know who's watching.
You don't. It is Monday, yes. The 23rd of July. You know, we get these emails, usually it's from Bert or Gladys or else. This is from Mr. and Mrs. I like the way that was put on the
that's
email.
That's very nice.
Mr. and Mrs. Jack Waller of Grantham. He says, my wife and I never miss Countdown.
Oh, that's nice.
And as you're on TV nearly every day of the year, which we are.
We are, aren't we? We're on five days a week.
Weekends.
Apart from some racing days.
Goodwood,
we've got Goodwood coming up.
Cricket, yeah.
And a couple of weeks around Christmas time.
Yeah, you know, until he said that, I didn't really realise how straight we are, you know.
Oh, I know.
Well, you retire, you wind it down as you get mature.
Do you?
More TV than I've ever done in my life, but however. He says, how do you and Carol relax? How do you relax? Well, what I do, I sit in the lounge.
Yeah.
And I'll put the lights down, get a soft drink, nothing mad. A little drink, little.
What's a soft drink?
Well, a bourbon and Sprite.
Normally, a soft drink means like a Fanta or.
Well,
a
I mean, it's not hard. It's. Yeah. I'm not that big. It's enough. And then I'll put some of the really good, easy listening music on, the Frank Sinatra, lots of Cole Porter.
Yeah.
I mean, what? How can you beat lyrics like "I'm with you once more under the stars, and down by the shore an orchestra's playing."
Oh.
Even the palms seem to be swaying when they begin. They begin. I mean,
oh,
well, you've got to relax, you
that's
see.
Lovely.
So that's what. What do you do then?
Well, I look particularly in the summer months. I love to have a barbie, and I love that time from about 6 o'clock onwards. It's lovely, isn't it? And the heat's gone out of the sun, but it's just still lovely. And having a barbie and putting on, because I've got all my music on my computer, like a lot of people do now. So I put, and on my music library now, I've got 4,273 songs.
Any of mine?
No.
I should talk to you later. I'll send one through the post. Mandatory, you should listen to one. Right, who's playing today? Well, David's here for his 7th show. So you've got this one and another one, and then if you do that, you're an Octochamp. He's our current champion at the moment, obviously, and doing particularly well. To get to that Octochamp situation, you've got to meet young John Anderson here. A Scottish gentleman, lives in Montrose in Scotland. He's a parish minister, which is the equivalent of an English vicar, is it not? Yeah, I think it is. Thereabouts, yeah. You're nodding quietly, or you're
It's the same, just different terminology north of the border.
OK, I'll take your word for that, sir. Married with two adult sons, plays the accordion. In or out of church, that's at home, is it? You
know, it's been done in church, but normally at home.
Normally at home, right. Enjoys chess and bridge. Favourite film is The Wizard of Oz. Well, I could while away the hours, John, but we've got a game to do. So will you welcome David and John playing today?
Well, our lovely guest all of this week knows everything there is to know about the movies. He's also pretty good at finding long words, so it could be said that he scores easy. That's like a movie gag, scores easy. Anyway, sitting alongside our small screen siren, the gorgeous Miss Susie Dent. Please welcome the fabulous Mr. Barry Norman.
Thank you, Carol.
So there we are, 6 o'clock in the evening. He's listening to Cole Porter or something. I'm not listening to Des O'Connor.
You're cooking a hamburger on the barbie for him.
What are you doing?
What am I doing?
Yes.
I'm probably doing the Times crossword puzzle.
Are you?
My wife and I have one each every day.
Oh, do you?
And we do it sort of in competition until sometimes it's very, very hard. And then we say, the hell with the competition. How are you doing? You know, have you got one across?
Do you do a photocopy in the morning? Is that
No. We buy a copy of the Times. Oh, no.
Two
photocopy's
copies.
Not the same. It's got to be done in the paper. Is that right,
Susie? Yeah, no, I agree.
Susie's another time. You've got to have the paper there.
Yeah.
You know, photocopying it, forget it. You know, it's like
well,
those jumbo books of crossword puzzles. They're not nearly as much fun.
Well, there you go. Well, while you lot are doing that, perfect, we've got a game to play.
Oh, yeah.
Right, and David, our current champion, is going to start us off with the first set of letters. There you go, David.
Hi, Carol. Hi. I'll start with consonant, please.
OK, thank you, David. C.
And another one.
D.
Vowel.
U.
And another one.
E.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
L.
Consonant.
B.
Vowel.
I.
And the final consonant.
Thank you, David. G.
Here's today's first clock. David, good start. What did you do?
Seven.
Seven, okay. And John?
Yeah, I think a seven.
You think a seven. Let's see whether you're right.
Burgled.
Burgled. I think that's fine, burgled, yeah. And David?
Builder.
Builder. Well, sure, that's fine. And what have we got in the corner, Barry?
Oh, we can't beat seven, can we?
No.
We've got Gilda.
Gilda?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not the girl's name, G-I, no. Gilda and what's the other one? Bludger?
Bludger.
Bludger. That's someone who's always... And they use that a lot in Australia.
Exactly. It is an Australian New Zealand word, and I was going to ask you if you knew it. It's a scrounger.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, a scrounger.
Someone's always on the ear. Right, this time it's John to put some letters up there.
Hello, Carol. Could I have a consonant, please?
You can, John. Thank you so much. T.
And a second one.
That was T, and this is S.
And a third one.
M.
A vowel, please.
A.
Another.
I.
A consonant.
P.
A vowel.
E.
A consonant.
N.
And a consonant.
And a consonant. You've got three vowels, yes. S.
Right, here's the clock. John, what do we get?
Eight.
Eight. Not bad. How about David?
Eight.
Eight. Good scoring game. This right, John, let's have yours.
Pastimes.
Pastimes is fine.
Same.
And looks like Barry, he's got pastimes.
Yeah, pastimes. Yep, right. Absolutely right.
2 8. Did we get an eight over there?
Excellent.
Of course.
Of course you did.
Of course we did. We got several, did we not? There's matiness, for a start.
Oh, I like that word.
Yeah.
Matiness.
Misspent.
Yes.
And what else have we got?
That was it, actually. Yeah, I'd scribbled pastimes.
Yeah, that's good. All right. Might be one of those days where it gives good scores all the way because the players got 15 points each. That's very good after two rounds. David, some letters from you.
Vowel, please.
Thanks, David. O.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
H.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
R.
Consonant.
Z.
Consonant.
W.
And another consonant.
And L.
Here's that clock. David, what have we got?
Seven.
Seven for you, John?
Six.
Six, right, let's hear that six.
Whaler.
Right, whaler, yep, fine. David?
Lover.
Lover?
Somebody who loves.
Yes, I think that's okay. I'll just double check. Loathe, yep, it's specified. Well done, David.
So
whaler, absolutely fine.
A loather is right. Anything over there?
Well, you've got another seven, which is waltzer.
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 Yes. One who waltzes.
Yes, one who waltzes.
Or that lovely fairground ride where we've got cars spinning round.
You don't go on those.
I love those.
Right, the scores are 22 to David, 15 to John. And John, once more, you're going to put the letters up there.
Consonant, please.
Thanks, John. D.
And a second one.
F.
And a third one.
S.
A vowel, please.
O.
A second vowel.
E.
A third vowel.
U.
A fourth vowel.
E.
A consonant.
N.
And a final consonant.
And a consonant. M.
Right, here's that clock. Right, John, what do we have?
Just six.
Just the six, David?
I'll risk a seven.
You're going to risk the seven. Well, let's go with your six first.
Mounds.
Mounds, yes.
Fondues.
Fondues, both good for six. Seven, sorry, that's seven, isn't
that
it?
That is, yes. Good, it's got the E at the end.
Yes.
Fondues.
Fondues. Yeah. What have we got in the corner, Barry?
Fondues.
Yeah. Yeah, fondues.
We can't beat
no,
that, can we?
It comes from melted, it means melted in French.
Okie dokie. Right, scores 29 playing to 15. And we're going to turn now to numbers. And David, you're pretty good with these, so there you go.
One or two?
One two, please.
Oh, one, two. One from the top, then two, then one, then two. Okay. Here we are, gentlemen. 4, 6, and 5. 7, 10, and 75 from the top. Nice selection and a nice target. 205.
Here's the clock. The numbers work out, David?
205.
And John?
204.
204, just the one away. Let's hear your 205, David.
10 minus 7 is 3.
10 minus 7 is 3.
Times 75.
Yeah, you're up to 225.
And 5 times 4 is 20.
Yeah.
And take away.
And take that away, 200.
That's 10 points, and David's got himself a healthy lead. Not unbeatable, but a healthy lead. As we say, and welcome, Barry. Nice to have you here, Barry.
It's nice to be here, Des. Always is. You know, this year is the centenary of the birth of the greatest actor I've ever seen or ever expect to see, and that is Laurence Olivier. And I knew him very well at the time when he was starting the National Theatre in London at the Old Vic. I mean, he's fantastic. He was a human chameleon. He could look like anything or anyone he wanted to look like. And one of his great successes at the very beginning of his time at the National, at the Old Vic, was Othello, in which he played the title role. And I had tickets for the second night of that. And I took my wife, Diana, along to the theatre. We got there early and we went into the pub next door to the Old Vic, which was a hangout for all the National Theatre actors. And we were talking to several of them. And then the door opened and in came this middle-aged, middle-sized man with grey hair, grey suit, battered briefcase. And he came over to me and said, hi. And I said, hello. This is my wife, Diana. Would you like a drink? Bought him half a bitter. We chatted a bit. And then he finished his drink. He said, well, I'd better go and get ready now. And off he went. And Diana said, who was that? I said, that was Laurence Olivier. Well, I tell you what, an hour or so later, we're in the theatre, the curtain goes up, and Olivier comes on as Othello. And I swear he was 7 feet tall and lithe and lean. And he glided across the stage. Magnificent actor. I mean, he took his performance to the very verge of caricature, and the audience is just about to start giggling nervously, and then he would do something quite breathtaking. Fantastic. Anyway, a few days later, I was back at the Old Vic on another errand and bumped into Olivier and congratulated him. And he thanked me and he said, you know, my wife, Joan Plowright, was in the audience that night, and she was waiting for me as I came off the stage. She was in the dressing room and she leapt up to give me a hug. And I said, oh no, let me get all this body makeup off first. And he said, I went into the shower as Othello and I came out as myself and her jaw dropped 6 inches.
Was he a nice man?
I found him so, yeah, I do. I found he did very kind things for me at the time, you know, when you know, at that time when I knew him very well. So, yeah, I mean...
You met... I'm going to say all the right things, but you've interviewed and met a lot of the real biggies and legends, yeah, over there. Was there a disappointment, someone you'd always thought, oh, that's a wonderful person, then you meet and, oh, my goodness me?
No, it wasn't a disappointment, because I never expected much of them, frankly. Yeah. You know, I mean, because I come from a film household, I was brought up... My father produced The Cruel Sea and directed Dunkirk and things, so I was brought up with actors, and I've always known that they're just working stiffs like you and me, Des, you know.
What did you call us?
I mean, you don't see daylight between their feet and the ground as they walk about. And I figured the only way was to pay them the compliment of treating them as my equals.
Yeah. I remember once when I was interviewing you, we talked about Marilyn Monroe. I'm going to chase you on that one, because she wasn't your favourite person. I remember that. Right now, we turn to a tea time teaser. And the words are rival can, that's R-I-V-A-L, rival can, with a C. Clue, an atmosphere at the street parade. An atmosphere at the street parade.
The countdown to the TV switchover has begun.
The Citroën C4 can transform the impact on your wallet and the environment. With only 120 grams CO2 per kilometre, it's the lowest in its class. Citroën C4, alive with technology. Just imagine what Citroën can do for you.
Need cheaper car insurance? Call the AA team on 0800 107 9071. We'll compare prices from over 20 insurers. We could save you up to 35% if you switch to us. With a full money-back guarantee if you find a cheaper quote. Call us now on 0800 107 9071 or visit theaa.com. The AA team. They're very keen, you know.
Yes,
come on.
Nice.
When I was a kid, you were lucky if you got to see one live game of Fortnite. A broken leg was something you tried to run off. A dodgy meat pie at halftime. And your dad's embarrassing goal celebration. Some things never change.
This season, watch up to 288 Barclays Premier League games for only £12 a month. Call BT Vision now on 0800 33 44 22.
What? Oh, no, no. I'm in the village of... I have no idea.
RAC mobile phone tracking means we can tell where you are, even if you can't. RAC, to the rescue.
When is a good deal not a good deal on home insurance?
When they attract you with introductory offers, but then you find out that there may be strings attached.
At Direct Line, we're currently offering all new customers 12 months for the price of 9. No catches. And if you don't make a claim on our home insurance, we'll give you a 10% discount when you renew. Plus, we're on the phone in UK-only call centres.
That's better.
Direct Line. A good deal better. Call 0845 246 8800 or visit directline.com.
TravelSupermarket.com compares the rates of over 100,000 hotels, over 50 car hire companies, and millions of flights, comparing quotes from online travel agents, tour operators, and budget and charter airlines.
Cool. We need to fly to Barcelona.
As soon as possible.
TravelSupermarket.com compares the market in seconds, making it easy for you to choose the best deal. TravelSupermarket.com, the price comparison site.
Come on, hurry up!
Officially arrived. It's coming up to 8:05. You're listening to the morning.
there's another way to enjoy the taste of English country life. New Country Life Lighter.
Childbirth on the NHS.
The midwife broke my waters and then just left me. Felt completely traumatised. It was horrific. It was horrible.
Dispatches. Undercover Mother. Tonight at 8 on 4.
Nearly all TVs can be converted to digital.
Right, the words were rival can, and the clue, an atmosphere at the street parade. I bet a lot of you got this. Carnival.
Oh, carnival. I love a carnival. You know, it's the first time I ever won a prize. Prestatyn Carnival, 1966.
What did you win?
Well, my brother stood me in the garden. We had a little patch of garden at the back of the flat, and he made me stand like that for 2 hours, and he hung a piece of elastic over my shoulders and a bike tie around there, and he draped me in a sheet, an old sheet, and he tied it round my thing, and he put a hat on my head and painted my face, and I won first prize as one of Ken Dodd's Diddy Men. It was a moment I'll never forget.
Well, I'll ring him up. Perhaps you could tour with him. They're still going around. Doddy will go on forever, please God. Right, we move back to the game. David's got the 39, John's got the 15. And John, once more, some letters.
A consonant, please.
A consonant, thank you, John. S.
A second one.
T.
A third one.
N.
A vowel.
O.
Another vowel.
E.
Another vowel.
A.
A consonant.
K.
A consonant.
J.
And a vowel.
And I.
Here's a clock. Right, John, how do we go there?
Seven.
Seven, and David?
Seven.
Seven, two sevens. Right, David, what have you got?
Intakes.
Intakes, and John?
The same word, intakes.
Same word indeed. There you are, intakes here. What have we got over there?
Well, I've got stink, which is appropriate, because all I've got is tokens, 1-6. But I think my little friend here has convinced
me. She usually wangles something more than six.
I was just looking up tokenist, but it's not that. It's tokenistic. But jokiest is there.
Jokiest. Well, we like that, jokiest.
Much
very
better.
Nice. Scores are 46 to David, 22 to John. There you go. Right, and this time it is David who will be putting the letters up there on the board.
Vowel, please.
Thanks, David. O.
And another one.
E.
Consonant.
L.
Consonant.
G.
And another one.
T.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
S.
And a final consonant.
And P.
Here's that clock. David, what do we have?
Seven.
Seven for you and for John?
Eight.
Eight. Right, let's go with the seven then.
Postage.
Postage, yep. And eight, John?
I think it's okay. Gloaters.
Gloaters.
There's no R in the selection. Oh, bad luck.
These things happen. David's got 53. John has got 22. And the corner's got what?
Well, we've got sevens as well. There's legates for seven, and
yes, members of clergy. Or you can just change to the last vowel. Legatos. Passages
beautiful.
Of music in smooth flowing.
Smooth and flowing. Right. Scores John has got 22 and some catching up to do. David's got 53. But, John, see what you can do with these letters.
Consonant, please.
R.
That's the one I missed last time. another one.
M.
A third one.
D.
A vowel.
A.
Another vowel.
E.
A third vowel.
A.
A consonant.
B.
A vowel.
O.
And a consonant.
And S.
Here's that clock. John, what about that time?
Six.
Six this time. And David?
Six.
Six. David, what's your six?
Broads.
Broads. Yep.
Beards.
Beards. Ah, broads and beards. And over there?
There is a seven there, a nice seven, though. Sambered. He sambered the night away. It's S-A-M-B-A-E-D.
He could waltz the night away?
Yeah. Yes.
Waltzed. The night
waltz.
Away.
Waltz. Sambered.
He didn't foxtrotted the night away, though, did he?
That comes up in the next round, Ben.
Okay. Right, 59 played 28. And we've got to get some letters now from David.
Start with a consonant, please.
D.
And another one.
C.
And another one.
P.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
O.
And another vowel.
And another vowel. And A.
Here's another clock. David, what do you have?
Seven.
Seven for you and for John?
Seven.
Seven, John. Let's have your seven.
Apricot.
Apricot, very nice too. And, and apricot there?
Yeah, he's got apricots as well.
What are you going to add to that? Don't say cream.
No, I tell you what, tapioca. Do you ever
have... Only at school.
It's horrible, is it?
Oh,
it's like
no.
Eating baby newts. Yeah. Anyway, that's what we've got for seven, tapioca. Okay.
Right, 66, 35. We're going to the numbers board again. And, John, what are you going to ask Carol for there?
Carol, could I have one large one and five small ones, please?
Five small. Of course you can, John. And this is what you have. Three and five, six and three, seven and 25, with a target of 332.
Here's the clock. Right, John, how do the numbers work out?
333.
333, just the one away again.
All the threes as well.
You got all the threes as well. Yep. Well, John, you go first.
Well, I multiplied 25 by 13, which is 6 plus 7.
Okay, so you said 6 plus 7 is 13, multiplied by the 25 is...
And that comes to 325.
325.
And then I added on the 8,
which is
the 5.
5 and the 3, yeah?
Yes. I think that's eight. Five and three is eight.
So it's a five and a three.
Yes.
And you can utterly confuse me now. Is all the threes
333?
Three.
That's right. And David? Looks like the same way.
Yeah. Yeah, he did it exactly the same way. Exactly the same, way I did it.
Is,
yeah.
Is that possible, Carol?
Yes, it is. It's about how you make the 13. I mean, there are other ways of doing it, but I made a 13 by saying 3 times 5 is 15, and then 6 over the other 3 is 2. Take that away. That gives you 13. Then you multiply by 25, 3 to 5, and then you're left with a 7. So I sort of covered that up to begin with, and then added it on at the end. 3, 3, 2. Yeah.
Right, the scores are 73 playing 42 as we go to a tea time teaser here. And the words are axe, that's A-X-E, axe party. Clue, never gives 100% but gives enough. So that's axe party, never gives 100% but gives enough.
The countdown to the TV switchover has begun.
HDI FAP diesel technology we use in our racing car to reduce particulate emissions is the same we use in our new 207SW and across our range. The new Peugeot 207SW, the drive of your life.
When heartburn strikes, you need fast relief. New Rennie Dual Action works fast to soothe and neutralise heartburn so you can get back to your day. New Rennie Dual Action. No Dual Action product works faster.
At Onken, we take strawberries and then add whole grains. Because it's the little things in life that make all the difference. Enjoy life the Onken way.
TravelSupermarket.com compares the rates of over 100,000 hotels, over 50 car hire companies, and millions of flights, comparing quotes from online travel agents, tour operators, and budget and charter airlines.
Cool. We need to fly to Barcelona.
As soon as possible.
TravelSupermarket.com compares the market in seconds, making it easy for you to choose the best deal. TravelSupermarket.com, the price comparison site.
Sometimes you need to look at things closely before you realise something's missing.
Take your car insurance. Does your provider offer all the cover you need? Cooperative insurance could save you up to £145 and includes loads of great benefits as standard, including named drivers earning no claims discount. So don't wait until you have an accident to find out if there's something missing from your car insurance. Call Cooperative Insurance on 0800 115 115 and you could save up to £145 today.
Ready to take serious action against wrinkles?
Last year, one collagen filler was bought in the UK every minute. Its unique formula contains silicon and collagen biospheres that inflate up to 9 times. Instantly, wrinkle furrows appear reduced as though filled. Now discover new L'Oreal Collagen Filler Eye with collagen biospheres and soft reflex texture. It instantly illuminates the look of dark circles.
In the blink of an eye, dark circles and wrinkle furrows appear reduced.
New Collagen Filler Eye from L'Oreal Paris.
Because you're worth it.
Fixident Food Seal has a thinner nozzle which allows for precise application. This helps to give a better seal against food infiltration. Fixident Food Seal, life with more bite.
What made Amanda Holden cry? Him, Paul Potts sings here live.
Plus Griff Rhys-Jones, why men are in mourning for stockings and suspenders, and the horrifying things kids get up to on their gap years. That's our daughter bungee jumping. Help.
You need to ensure all your TVs are converted to digital.
The words were axe party, axe party. And the clue, never gives 100% but gives enough. And the answer, taxpayer. Oh. Right, let's get back to the game. 73, David, 42 to John. David, some letters on the board, please.
Start with a vowel, please.
Thank you. E.
Consonant.
L.
Another consonant.
M.
And another one.
Mm-hmm. N.
Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
G.
Consonant.
V.
Consonant.
N.
And a final vowel.
And A.
Here's the clock. David, what do we have there?
Six.
Six for you. And John?
Six.
Six, David?
Mangle.
Bangle.
Mangle.
Mangle. I was going to say, where's the B? Mangle.
The same word.
Yes, mangle. Same again. Mangle. Both been through the mangle. What have we got in the far corner?
Well, it wasn't a great, inspiring selection, was it? We've got Gunman.
Gunman.
Six.
Yeah, that is one word. We had Hitman quite recently, which is two words. But Gunman is one.
Isn't that strange? Yeah. I wonder who makes these.
I think
these
it's probably
rules.
Because Gunman is used more often, and so there's more evidence of use. And the more people use it at the moment, hyphens are just falling out.
Right. 79, 48. John, we'd like you this time to put the letters once again.
Consonant, please, Carl.
Thank you, John. T.
And another.
L.
And a third.
N.
And a fourth.
R.
A vowel, please.
I.
A second one.
E.
A third one.
I.
A consonant.
D.
And another vowel, please.
And a vowel. And E.
Here's the clock. Right, David, what do you have?
A risky seven.
Risky seven. You didn't seem too happy about that one. What about you, John?
Well, I think it's a safe seven.
A safe seven. Let's go with a risky one first.
Tendril. Tendril. T-E-N-D-R-I-L.
I think that sounds right.
Yes, that's
tendril.
Fine.
John?
Relined.
Relined.
Relined. I thought you were thinking of that one too. But yes, that's absolutely fine. It's in the dictionary now, as in relined your curtain. Right. Tendril's also fine. It's basically the long, thin appendage of a plant or stem of a plant.
Okay.
It's a tendril.
And what about our corner? What have we got?
And the corner is just keeping pace. We've got another seven, which is tide line.
Yes, it's eight, actually.
That's eight? No, good Lord. I can't even count. I write it down and I can't count the letters. Eight.
Right,
eight.
Right, 86, player 55. David, you're knocking up a good score here. Might be your best ever score the way you're going at the moment. And it's your turn to put the letters up on the board.
Vowel, please.
Thank you, David. A.
And another one.
E.
Consonant.
P.
And another one.
C.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
N.
And another one.
S.
And another vowel. Another consonant, Carol.
You confuse me now. Yeah. D.
And another vowel.
And a vowel.
Yeah.
OK. A.
Here's the clock. What do we have, David?
Seven.
Seven for you, and what's John got to offer?
Seven.
Seven again. John, let's have your seven.
Candies.
How do you spell that?
C-A-N-D-I-E-S.
Now, Candies, yes. And
that's
over there?
We've
got Candies as well.
Candies all around.
Yeah. And we've got Candies, and she's got Candies.
Have we?
Yeah.
Candies all over.
We have.
She's got the book out, though.
No, I was just looking to see where it came from. It comes from a word meaning crystallised sugar.
Crystallised, simple as that.
Simple as
which
that.
Is basically what it is. Right, what's the score? It's 93. You're looking, though, you might hit that 100 for the first time. 62 to John, very respectable score. John, some numbers from you, please.
The same again, Carol, please. One large one.
One large.
And five wee ones.
Okay. Wee ones?
A wee ones.
A wee ones. Thank you. 10 and 9 and 3. 2 and another 10 and 100. Lots of zeros there. And big target, 704.
Right, here's the clock. John, those numbers, 704, what do you get?
704.
704, you look surprised.
I am.
And over there, David.
704.
704. Let's go with John, 704 first.
Seven.
Where's the seven?
When? Yes, I got three from ten.
Okay, 10 minus three gives you seven.
Okay, the other 10 divided by two is five.
Yeah.
Subtract the 5 from the 9.
Yeah, it gives you 4.
Four.
So you've done 7 times 100, haven't you?
Uh-huh. I
plus
forgot that. Aye,
yeah. And that's 704.
704, there you go. David?
9 minus 2 is 7.
Oh, you've made the 7 a different way. 9 minus 2 is 7 multiplied by 100, yeah?
It's 700, add on the 3.
Yeah.
And 10 over 10 is 1.
Lots of divisions going on. We don't often get that, do we? And add that up. 10 points, gentlemen.
There you go. Well, David, you've got to hit the 100 there, 103, and the 72 to John, so John can't win this, but as I always say, it's nice to go out with a conundrum under your belt. Right, fingers on the buzzers, right, as we reveal today's countdown conundrum. Right, David?
Loitering.
Loitering. Let's have a little look. Yeah, excellent. Well, we did say that David was good at those. That seems to be your speciality, the conundrums, and you ended up with a score of 113, so you are today's winner. And tomorrow, when you get back, you'll be trying that big one, the Octochamp game.
Pressure's on.
Pardon?
The pressure's on.
The pressure's on. Well, you've managed to deal with it so far. Same with saying, it's a shame we're saying goodbye so quickly to John. You're back up to Montreal. You get the goodie bag.
Thank you.
And I'm going to ask you one thing. How come, Barry, you've written over a dozen books, you never really tackled a film script. Why not?
Oh, because you don't really have a control over a film script. You know, you write a script, a producer buys it, and he says things like, oh, you've set it in London, but I've got money in Budapest. Can we change it to Budapest?
Really?
Yeah, and then the leading man comes along and says, look, this is a buddy story, but there's this little chick I'm interested in, so can we change the buddy into a girl? And so it goes on, till in the end, what appears on the screen's got nothing to do with what you wrote in the first place. Whereas with a book, it's all yours, and in those moments when you think, oh, what have I ever achieved, at least you've got something on the shelf with your name on the jacket, and you think, ah, I did that. You
know. That's understandable. Oh, maybe you'll do it one day. Maybe.
Well, yeah, there's maybe. More money in film scripts than there is in novels.
Right, well, we'll all be back tomorrow. Carol, Susie, all of us on the team, 3:30 countdown. See you then. Bye.
Shameless and Coronation Street actor Chris Bisson is one of Empire's children, tracing his roots back to Trinidad at 9 o'clock tonight. Next on 4, Nick Hancock is the boss in our game show, where the challenge is win my wage.
You don't need to buy a new TV for the switchover, as nearly all existing TVs can be converted to digital.
Oh.